So where am I today? I'm in Cheltenham. My name's Cyan Astley and I'm here with Real Homes to have a look at some of the most amazing Instagram houses in the UK. This is Dee Campling's house. She's an Insta queen, of course, and an interior designer. I'm dying to go and have a look inside this house. Come with me, let's go and have a nosy. Oh, hello. Hello. Hello, this is Ted. Hello, Ted. How are you? Hello. I'm dying to come and look at this house. Before we have a good look around the house, and I'm dying to have a nosy, I've got to say, what is your style? What do you think encapsulates the Dee Campling look?
We ask people to do this actually on our workshops. We ask them to describe their style, and I'd call myself bohemian, Scandi eclectic. Right. And I think if you name it, of a name for it, you can make it up yourself, then it actually helps you to kind of home in on things that will suit you. So yeah, I like lots of natural textures, lots of natural elements. I like lots of neutrals. I like to be able to mix things up with vintage and new, high street and designer, you know, and I always go for things I love. I don't worry about trends. Mm.
Follow your own path.
Follow my own path, very much so, yeah.
Have you always had the confidence to do that?
I don't suppose I've always been confident. I'm sure I've, you know, wavered a lot, but I've never copied anybody else. No, I've always been really keen to, I don't know why, but I just don't like following trends or being told what to do, so I like to do my own thing.
Do you think you're a bit of sort of a hippie at heart?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
You like the natural, organic?
Yeah, I like the outdoor life. We go camping every year. I was born in the countryside, so it's always been about, you know, making the most of what's around you, and I like nothing more than being outside in the country.
Do you like finding treasure?
I love finding treasure,
I sense you're a treasure kind of person. What treasure do you find?
I love just collecting flowers and branches. That log next to you was pinched from a campsite. Yeah, it might go on the fire later. And I get lots of inspiration, I think, from the outdoors as well. So just how, you know, nature's brilliant at putting colours together, isn't she? So I think my biggest style secret is, you know, people buy vintage and they think, you know, you have to go to an antiques dealer to buy your vintage, or you have to spend weeks and weeks scouring all these auction houses. But I get nearly all of it from eBay because someone's done that work for you already. And my watch list is always like embarrassingly long. So yeah, if I'm buying vintage, I very rarely buy it from an antiques place.
Well, it's more expensive to buy
It's more expensive, and you know, I think those things as well, everything I like, and I'm sure this is the same for anybody, whatever you know, that has nearly always been done before, and it's always a vintage version of it. So I'd much rather buy something with a bit of character and age to it than buy the new version. Yeah. So eBay is my go-to stuff.
Are you a late night eBayer? I'm a late night eBayer. I'm sort of in bed and having
that's on my phone. Yeah, I used to be, before I had our phones, I was on it in that computer room, like always just looking for things. And I was in labour one day and I didn't go into hospital because I was busy on something.
Because you didn't want to miss. I can't believe that. That's absolutely, that's quite extreme. That's quite hardcore eBaying.
Hardcore, yeah. But no, don't be worried about living with an empty space. If you've got a gap to fill, 99% of interior design mistakes are made by people who rushed out to buy a cupboard to fill a space because Auntie so-and-so is coming round and you don't want it to look unfinished. And then you have to spend 20 years living with that thing to make it pay for itself. And I think if you just hold on, live with the space, fill it with a plant or something if you're worried about it. But you know, live with that space and wait for the right thing to come up and you will find it.
What about colour? What are the colours which really talk to you, which may you want to have them in your house?
Yeah, well, I absolutely love natural colours. So all the neutrals, whites, blacks, greys, kind of colours you get from nature. So kind of, you know, colours of wood. I love wood. I think, you know, wood's a brilliant foil to most things, and greenery. I wouldn't have green paint, but I would have green accessories.
That's very particular. Yeah. That's very specific.
I don't know why. I think maybe because I don't like green as a wall colour. I don't know why. I wouldn't necessarily have wallpaper or anything like that because, again, it's something you can get bored with quite quickly. Again, a lot of people, if you're a pattern person, if you wear a lot of patterns, if you enjoy patterns, then go for it. But I know, look what I'm wearing.
That's not your style.
But so the more neutral you can keep it, the more of a blank canvas you've got to showcase the things that you love, the things you love.
And it's all about, for you, I mean, I'm already seeing in this room as we look, it's about layering textures and things that are very tactile. Is that something that you like?
I think it's
well?
A brilliant way. I think lock texture is a brilliant, especially if you're like me, you're not a massive fan of colour or wallpaper and pattern, then to stop a room from looking boring, you need textures. And I love textures. I love, again, back to the plant thing. I think a room can take as many textures as you want to throw at it, and it just adds it. It makes it look cosier and cosier. Yeah. Whereas if you were adding colour, it'd look busier and busier and stress me out. Whereas textures make it just add it. It makes it, I like, you know, velvet and rattan. I like putting those together. And
So very calming then.
Yeah,
things that are calming.
Yeah.
When you say you don't like things where it's too busy because it stresses you out. So I suppose a tip for people would be, if they're the sort of person who feels quite stressed out when they're in a busy environment and lots going on, actually in their house, it would be far better to have that calming, textured,
probably,
organic.
Yeah, absolutely. Especially in this day and age where everyone's stressed out to the max, aren't they? And I think I wouldn't ever tell anyone how they should decorate, but I would say, you know, the most important thing is to work out how do you want to feel at home. And if you actually put a name on that, that will help to guide you as well. And the vast majority of people I speak to want to feel relaxed at home and feel soothed. And you get that from neutral colours and cosy textures and the log fire. All those, you know, that kind of moment you want to create to make yourself feel relaxed. And other people might be working in a boring office and want to come home to some colour because they're so bored with that.
Yeah. And you know, the amazing thing is, you even have a textured dog.
I do, that was part of my, he's on the... I know, quite often people say that, he lies on the sheepskins, you actually can't see he's there.
Yeah, the perfect dog for this house.